Today we're looking at bathroom extractor fans.
And we're looking at the Envirovent Silent Dual 100, Gordon.
Now, I like a product where the key to success is in the name and the silent bit. This product is a whisper quiet. It's actually on now as we're shooting the video. The second bit is the Dual, and that's its two modes of operation using either a humidity sensor or a PIR that we're going to look at a little bit further.
Okay, and there's two ways in which to set it up. Which way are we going to set it up first, Gordon?
So just let's have a look at the intermittent mode first. So that's normally when there's nobody in the bathroom and no humidity detected, the fan is off.
Okay, so you're saying when somebody's introduced, maybe humidity or somebody moving in, the fan will change its status.
Yeah, well, let's introduce some humidity with the eFIXX Apprentice Hub mug. Some nice steaming hot water there. You'll see that the fan's immediately detected that and switched on. Now, if a lot of humidity is detected, it goes to 100% straight away. If only a small amount of humidity is detected, it gradually ramps up to 100%. Depending on the humidity level.
And we'd blanked out the PIR there, so that was actually working with nobody in the room, maybe nobody even in the building, that it detected humidity and actually the fan turned itself on and started to clear that humidity.
Yeah, so obviously the main reason for an extractor fan is to clear steam, humidity, and avoid mold. So that is a really useful function that it's not reliant on, you know, at the moment most people it's tied to the light switch with that run-on timer. Well, that run-on timer makes no account of actually real humidity levels.
Okay, and the second part of the feature, which we'd blanked out in the first part of the video, means that we now introduce the PIR element. So all of a sudden now we've walked into the area. What's happened to the extractor fan now, Gordon?
Okay, so the extractor fan under these circumstances immediately comes on at 75% of full output. Now obviously the reason for the PIR is you might want to remove some air in the bathroom that's a little bit stale for some other reasons, and obviously when a person's in the room, that's the chance when you need to do that.
So I've walked into the bathroom, I've used the bathroom but maybe not used a shower or bath to create humidity. The extractor fan's come on when I'm in the area. Will it stay on for an actual amount of time?
Yeah, so then there is a run-on timer that people are probably used to with lots of existing extractor fans, and you can set that to either 2 or 15 minutes with one of the dip switches that we'll look at a little bit further.
However, let's say I've gone into the bathroom, I've actually had a bath or shower, created some humidity, okay, and I've obviously left the area, and say I've set it to 2 minutes, will the extractor fan turn itself off when I'm no longer in the area for 2 minutes?
Yeah, so it's the humidity sensor always takes priority. So okay. Regardless of a time setting, if there's humidity, it will still continue to run and operate until that's cleared.
So I've come out of the bathroom, it's really steamy in there, that 2 minutes is overridden by the fact it needs to clear the humidity.
Yeah.
That's the first mode in which you can set using those two dip switches, and we'll have those dip switches later in the presentation. But let's say we've changed them to the next setting. What's the next mode that you can
have? Okay, so let's repeat the operation with the continuous mode. So that's where the fan runs at 43% of full output for all of the time.
Okay.
In a sort of trickle ventilation mode. And again, if humidity is detected, it goes up to either immediately to 100% or gradually increases to full output depending on the humidity level.
So let's just recap that. So it's running all the time?
All the time, yeah.
Okay, but once it creates some humidity in the area, it can ramp up maybe to 100% in order to clear it. And I leave the area, and again, it's going to continue to run at 43%?
Yeah, 43%.
So before we go any further, people are going to say to yourselves, that's using power. Can you describe the power levels of the machine?
Okay, so this particular version, the 100 version for a 100 millimeter pipe, it goes between 4 and 8 watts depending on that mode of operation.
Okay,
so that's not a huge amount of power.
I think the benefit of not having a damp bathroom compared to maybe using 4 watts of energy, I imagine we'd all want to have it on and extracting away. So they're the two modes. So let's have a look from the installer's point of view, how we got to it, how do we fix it, how do we connect the cables, and importantly, how do we change those dip switches. So let's look at the next one. So in this, we can see we're fixing all four corners, which is obviously what we expect. We've got a PIR and we've got the humidity detector as well built within the actual unit itself. So when we go to connect the cable, Gordon.
Okay, so it's just two cores to connect. It's a double insulated fan. So again, you've got to leave the earth well away from the terminal. So yeah, most people, as you've done there, just double it back and leave it oversleeved, but within the enclosure. But let's think, that's only two connections, so there's no secondary permanent live or switch live to think about. It just needs that permanent live connection so the sensors are always ready to operate.
And we just see now we've put the grommet back as well. So we've connected it up, not the three core menu that we used to, just two cores. We've folded the CPC out of the way. And obviously we're now ready to energize it. But we talked about those dip switches. Shall we have a look at that next, Gordon?
Yeah, so the dip switches, there's only two of them. So a lot of these fans you'll see, there's masses of dip switches. This one comes with a little tea stirrer there that you use to access the dip switches, which you flip back this little cover. Nice thing, electronics are under this sort of, again, secondary sealed unit, so you don't get moisture into the actual electronics, and you just flip the dip switch to the required setting.
So there's just a couple of selected modes. One will be between 2 and 15 minutes, and one's between intermittent and what do you call the other one?
Or continuous mode.
Continuous mode. So that's nice and simple. It's fully in the instructions explaining that. As well as the IP rating of the actual enclosure. What is it, Gordon?
Yeah, so this is an IP45 fan. So what does that mean in terms of zones, Gary?
Okay, so we can wall mount it or ceiling mount it. So, okay, and it can go inside of zone one. I suppose if you're going onto the ceiling, the likelihood is you'll be outside of zone one, but it can be installed in zone one if you have to. Also comes with the warranty, Gordon?
Yeah, so it's a 5-year warranty. So again, quality build, 5-year warranty back to it. That's a great option.
And just to remind everybody, it's been running the whole time the video's on, and we're not shouting over the top of it, are we?
Let's just stop the PIR, just kick it off again.
Oh, there we go. So
it's back again. So some of the other features, again, mentioned the electronic sealed in there, which makes it a very neat unit. Again, a lot of problems with extractor fans caused by moisture getting trapped in and affecting the electronics that do the timer functions. The other thing I like is the fan cover itself. It's a kind of hybrid between the a fully open front or these fully flat front. It's got sort of, you can have some direct input to it and some intake from the side as well. So
So once those screws are in and down, they're simply covered by putting the front plate on. Why is that such a bonus to have that easily removed, Gordon?
Yeah, well, that's very easy to clean. It's just, it just literally lifts off the front. And then you can
wipe it over and pop it back on. That's great. That's fantastic. So we've seen some really key features there, okay, for the electrician. You said it can run all the time, and I know it's got that little plastic flap at the back.
So if it's running in a continuous mode of operation, you can remove the backdraft shutters there. So they just simply detach from the back. But I say that's only in if it's a continuous mode operation.
Okay. So our feelings on this fan then, so Gordon, so run through the things you really like.
Well, I love the fact it's very easy to install, so the electricians will love it, and it offers basically peace of mind for the customer that it's always going to operate in the right mode of operation, whisper quiet, but you know, will extract when it needs to and just sit there waiting to extract when it doesn't need to.
And from my point of view, I've got a family with two children in that don't tend to pull the other pull cord that actually puts my extractor fan on. My bathroom has no window in it, and obviously got a ton of problems there with obviously the build of humidity in that area, whereas this one takes it away from me. I could just install one of these and it's going to automatically come on and clear that. Mm. As always at eFIXX, we're interested in the type of extractor fan you're fitting. Are you fitting Envirovent, any of their range? What's your feeling on them? We'd love to have your comments below, so please make sure you leave them below, and us and Envirovent will attempt to get back to as many as we can.